Hello students, welcome back to your English class. I am back with another story from your supplementary reader book, that is A Pact with the Sun. This is chapter number 8. Also the name of the chapter is A Pact with the Sun. So what is the meaning of pact? Pact means keeping a promise between two individuals, two parties, something they both have agreed upon and will follow it. So here in this story, Saida and her mother lives in a small house, and the story is revolving around them only. And the pact with the sun is all about a pact made between sun and Saida, the girl in the story. The sun promises something to Saida and he fulfilled that promise. So the story is all about that. It revolves around girl whose mother was sick. Saida's mother is sick, and in prayers to the sun help her mother recover from her illness. How? We will see in the story. Now as you can see, Saida's mother was very very ill. She had been ailing for a long time. That means she is ill for a very long time now. She had fever, cough, body ache, painful joints and whatnot. So all these symptoms were there, and she was very ill from a very long time, and she had all these problems going on with her. Now she had been treated by several physicians for weeks now, but she showed only signs of improvement from time to time, but only temporarily. That means if she was given some medicines, she was taking it and her condition was improved, but then after a few days or few weeks, again she is going back to the same condition. She is relapsing to the same condition. She was not allowed to eat normal food, and physicians who were treating her time to time, 1, 2, 3, whatever physicians they were treating her, they told her that she has to be confined to a small room with no sunlight or fresh air coming inside. She was not allowed to go out, and without the door was a dingy room with doors and windows fastened, that means closed, deprived of sunshine and fresh air, because she was not getting any sunshine or fresh air. These were all the advices of the physicians who were treating her. Now when she became very very critical, her relatives and neighbor persuaded her, that means told her for like much time, that please consult a specialist. So they told her that you should consult a specialist, even though the fees of the specialist is very high, but life is more precious than money. So she was very poor, but she asked her relatives to yes, call a specialist so that she can get better, and in order to pay his fees, she sell a few trinkets. That means a jewelry, a piece of ornament or a jewelry of a very small value. So she asked them to sell that so that they can arrange for the fees of the specialist. Now the specialist comes in a few days. He examined her, diagnosed her, prescribed effective but costly medicines obviously. He also spoke to her very empathetically, that means very nicely, very normally. And when he was talking to her, she asked to him that what she should be eating. So he said, anything you wish to eat, anything, chapati, vegetable, milk, fruit. So he was not telling her to not eat something. He was advising her to eat anything she wants to eat in order to get better. And also she was to sit in bigger, she was to be shifted into a bigger room and leave this room. And the room should have doors and windows open, and she has to sit in sun every morning for 8 to 9, from 8 to 9, that means for 1 hour, so that she can have that sunshine and fresh air, which are more important than the medicine according to the specialist. So she said all of these things. So all these advices given to her became the subject of comments among all the relatives present there, and some opposed it, some went with it, but people gave her advice around her, that one experienced lady said that exposure to the sun and air for someone who has cough and joint pains and everything is very dangerous. I am experienced. Please listen to me. So all these similar things were said by other people also, that the doctor is advising you this and that, you should not follow it. But she said, whatever you are saying is okay, but I am going to follow the orders of the doctors. So please move me into a bigger room and keep a cot, a charpai, that means a cot, into the veranda so that I can sit there and in the morning to have my fresh air and dose of sunlight. A younger neighbor nearly quarreled with her over this. Too exhausted to participate in the debate, Saida's mother did not quarrel back, did not answer back. She just simply declared that she is going to follow the advice of the doctor. Now, it so happened that the sky remained overcast the next morning. That means there were clouds. The sun rays were not properly coming in. Not at all coming in. So next 2 days happened. There was hardly any sun. Saida heard the same was the case the following day also. So for two days there was no sunlight. Saida's mother was dejected and being muttered to herself. That means she was very sad. And then she started talking to herself that, oh Lord of mine, why have you ordered the sun to remain hidden? How will I ever be cured? She was very worried. Saida was playing with her doll and she heard her mother saying this, all of this. But she did not say anything at that time. Later in the afternoon, when she was roaming and playing in the courtyard, she saw a very pale spot of sunshine. That means a very single ray of sunshine. So she ran to her mother and said, Amma, the sun is here. But she said, it's too late and chilly. Your mother can't sit out there. So it was not a good time for her to sit outside in the sun. Disheartened, Saida returned to her doll. There was no sun really, except for its last remnant. That means it was going to set soon. So she was very disheartened that her mother could not get any sunshine that day. So she prays to the sun and asks him to be there on the next day, to which sun replies, dear sister, do come tomorrow with lots of warmth and brightness. You see, my mother is ill and needs your help. This was the prayer from Saida. So sun says, surely don't look unhappy, we will be here at the fixed hour. See, she says all this to the sun rays, and so sun rays promise her that they will be there on the fixed hour. Now the children have at their command a secret language foreign to grown-ups altogether, in which they fluently communicate with trees, flowers, animals and the sun and the moon. So using that special language only, Saida requested the sun rays, departing sun ray, saying that do come tomorrow. So early next day, when the sprinkly sun rays embellished themselves for their journey, the sun set. When sun rays were ready to go to the earth, sun set, it's our day off again. We are staying up here. The road to the earth is blocked by an army of thick mucky clouds. So sun says them that today is also a day off. That means we have a holiday. We are not to go to the earth, because road to the earth, that means a path to the earth, is being blocked by a thick mucky clouds filled with all water. The little rays so much wanted to go down for the lark, but they remained quiet for some time. They did not want it to oppose their master. One of the rays, though, who made a pact with little Saida, raised an objection. Now there are a lot of sun rays coming from the sun, and the particular ray which made a pact, that means a promise to Saida, said to the sun, sir, I can't stay back. I have given my word to Saida, whose mother is ill and needs our help. I will pierce through the clouds to reach Saida's courtyard. How else will her mother be cured? So this ray, sun ray, was very, very concerned about Saida's mother's health, and that ray said to the sun that I have made a promise and I am not going to break my promise. Please let me go. I will pierce through the clouds. That means I'll make my way from in between the clouds and will reach to Saida's courtyard. Hearing this, all the race nearly staged a revolt against their father and spoke in a single voice. Now, all of them, the son was objecting and saying, no, you can't go. But all the race together said that, yes, we should not be staying back. If we would stay back, what will the people of the earth will say about us? That we make promises to them and then we break those promises easily. That means we are liars. So to that, son said, okay, but please mind your clothes. Though the clouds are mucky, that means they can rain at any time. They are mucky and then they will wet your clothes. So something like that, the son said to the race. And the race rushed towards the earth. The clouds stood guard between them and Saida's courtyard. The little ray focused their heat and they had enough of it at the bastion of the clouds, which had to flee from its post. That means clouds had to go from there, and then sun reached nicely down. Shooting past, they were already late. Of course, the rays were already late, but they anyhow reached to the courtyard. Amma, Amma, the sun is here, Saida shouts. Saida saw the whole host of them approaching and her heart leapt with joy. She was very happy that sun rays kept their promise and they are here. The old lady's eyes welled up with tears of gratitude. Her cot, charpai, was placed in the courtyard and she sat on it for an hour, reclining against the bolsters. That means reclining, that means sitting with comfortably along with the pillows there. So she sat there for an hour and she was very happy. Saida was Saida's mother was very, very happy to see the sun. And it had been months since she had felt the sun on her hands and face, because she was inside the dingy room, that room without any fresh air or sunlight. So she was very happy. And after months, she was experiencing the rays of the sun on her hands. She breathed in the fresh air. She thought that she is totally in a new world. She saw her child too bathed in sunlight and kissed her. The morning air brought in a new fragrance from nearby flowers. That means new perfume like smell from the flowers. The birds chanted a new tune. Saida's mother felt better already. Now this has been happening for many days, that after this day the sun rays came every other day and she used to sit in the sun rays and have fresh air. Along with that, she was eating properly, she was taking medicines properly, and now she is fully recovered. But she still follows the doctor's advice of an hour sunlight and lungfuls of fresh air every day. So she is still following the advice of the doctor and she is not skipping any day of sitting into the sun for an hour and taking in the fresh air. But she is proper now. She is totally recovered. She does not have any kind of illness. So this is how our story ends here. The moral of the story is that sunshine and fresh air are essential for a living healthy life. It also guides us to follow logical scientific principles, that if doctor says something or a specialist will advise something, we should be following it in order to keep our health better rather than believing the outdated superstitions or practices. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you understood the story well. Read this story from your supplementary reader book and let me know if you have any doubts. I will see you in next class. Till then, please take care and be safe.